principal officers of the University of Benin, members of Senate, Provost, College of Medical Sciences, deans of faculties and schools, professors and members of council, my lords, spiritual and temporal, staff and students of the University of Benin, gentlemen of the press, distinguished invited guests, ladies and gentlemen. It is with great pleasure that I welcome you all to the 246th in the inaugural lecture series of the University of Benin. Today's lecture is the 18th to be delivered in my tenure as Vice Chancellor of this great university. The 24th in the Faculty of Life Sciences, the 12th in the Department of Animal and Environmental Biology, the 2nd in the field of entomology, and the 1st in medical entomology. The very first in medical entomology. I am glad to report that the second semester examinations have commenced in the Faculty of Education and Department Entomology. I want to use this opportunity to solicit for the cooperation of all semester examinations in the University of Medicine to ensure the education of the second semester examinations. Professor Felix Irobe Aikosuna was born on the 18th of April 1991 into the family of late Inspector Edward Taiye Aikosuna retired, and his comfort became Inspector Aikosuna Oyemaye from Orange Land of Omaha West local government area of Edo State. He had his primary education at the Lutheran Primary School Yaro from 1967 to 1970, and his secondary education at Bamet High School from 1973 to 1978. He thereafter obtained his higher secondary education, HSC, at Advanced College in Western Edo State in 1980. He attended the University of Jos for his undergraduate program, where he obtained a BS in zoology in 1980. After 1 year mandatory national research, he returned to the University of Jos for his master's program in applied entomology and parasitology, and he obtained his master's in 1990. He obtained his PhD in medical entomology through the World Health Organization sponsorship program from the University of Georgia in 1997. He got an appointment as lecturer to the Department of Animal and Environmental Biology, formerly the Department of Zoology at the University of Illinois, in 1996. And he rose through the ranks to the position of full professor in 2008. His research interest in entomology, with special emphasis on medical coon, veterinary entomology, advanced mammalogy, and management of non-renewable resources. Professor Aikosuna has held many academic and administrative positions within and outside the University of Benin, among which are Chairman Ad Hoc Disciplinary Committee on Examination Misconduct, Faculty of Life Sciences, 2010, Representative of Entomology Unit and Departmental Quality Assurance Committee in 2017. Chairman, annual committee to look into the contract job in the Faculty of Life Science in 2012. That's a renovation. Chairman, Faculty of Life Sciences for Life Committee, 2006 to 2010. Chairman, Life Sciences Town and Gown Symposium 2016-2018. Chairman, Committee of Life Science Academia Industry Interface. Vice Chancellor Initiative, University of Virginia, 2015-2018. Professor Akpodio has said, as a member of accreditation panel, resource person, assessor to external examiner, moderator to several institutions, a facilitator and a consultant to notable international and national affairs and corporations. He has supervised 2 PhDs, 7 masters, 5 PhDs, and 60 BSc candidates. He has attended and presented several papers at conferences within and outside the country, and has 37 publications in local, national, and international journals and books. Professor Akpodio is a member of the Entomological Society of Nigeria and America, Nigerian Society for Parasitology, Ecological Society of Nigeria, and a fellow of the Royal Society of Tropical Medicine and Hygiene, London. He is a recipient of several awards and recognitions, such as University Research Publication Grant in 1998 and University Research Publication Grant in 2004. He was also recognized in the Who's Who in Nigeria in 1999. In 1999 publication, and was awarded an Ambassador of Science by National Association by National Association of Life Science Students in 2013. Professor Felix Irobe Akpodio is happily married and the union is blessed with 6 children. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor to invite Professor Felix Irobe Akpodio, a professor of zoology and medical entomology, to deliver his inaugural lecture.
I will not waste time because we don't have time. Madam Vice Chancellor, Principal Officer of Senate, Members of Senate, Provost of College of Medical Sciences, Deans, Directors, Academic and Non-Academic Colleagues, University Students, Great University, yes, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, glory, honor, and adoration to God Almighty for taking me this far, presenting my inaugural lecture. Thanks a million for your esteemed presence, and may God grant you a heart desire. This 246 inaugural lecture series of University of Benin is the 12th lecture to be delivered by Department of Animal and Environmental Biology in over 45 years of its existence. It is also the second inaugural lecture in the field of entomology and the first in medical entomology. The first lecture in entomology was delivered by Professor Mrs. B. M. Ilova in October 2016 on the topic Insects, Our Weaknesses in Life and in Death. My lecture today titled Strategy of Our Unfavorable Visitor, B.M. Ilova, we use it in October 2016 on the topic Insects, Our Weaknesses in Life and in Death. My lecture today titled Strategy of Our Unfavorable Visitor, B.M. Ilova, we use it in
October 2016,
blood inside of the mosquito. even just about on the 10th, when the last Inaugural journal has brought home, as I saw that Journal of Medical Pneumology is at praising this paper. Even just about telling that on the 10th, when the last Inaugural journal. Is less polluted for its cost. Sanitation should have its order of the day for control. These are our visitors. I'm sure many of us.
Of intellectual species and spiritual connections.
The number of enemies that mosquitoes cause in the places other than important city went from 8.7% to 20%. Those were 39.7% of the species and data, and the level of species that mosquitoes cause. The former two were the report that went from 9.7% to 20%. Great important direct impact on control of these diseases by the level of species that mosquitoes cause. The former two were the report that we made. If insecticides are administered, great important direct impact on control. Multi-balanced age. It's old enough to transmit to the other country. So, Coolers, 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 Coolers
not fairly to be and not fairly to wrestle in this exercise selection. The most abundant ones we do tonight are chickens.
I think this one is
get it is that
of 4,372 adults in the health care system.
The daily biting cycle showed in bimodal peak, the first was 10 to 12, while the second was 14 to 16 hours. Biting intensity was highest at 400 meters from river. I was 10 to 12, while the second was 14 to 16 hours. This was actually intensity was highest at 400 meters. This is my board. It's nice. Exercise weight should be restricted to 10 to 12 hours, 14 to 16 hours during training season. Workers outdoor is most common. Travelers talk into the exercise weight at least restricted to 10 to 12 hours, 14 to 16 hours during training season. Workers outdoor is most common. The quest for food security has become one of the critical issues of human population. Where protein supplement is abysmally low and usually out of nutrition from food. This study therefore involves evaluating the effect of correct genital and mechanical diets on gallus gallus. The body weight of the bears was not significantly different, whereas a significant trend arose at week 8. This preliminary study shows that insect enhanced meat could be used as an alternative fuel to the fermentation stage of development, whereas a significant trend arose as our human. I could be able to talk to you that insect enhanced cockroach constitute nuisance in home as an alternative. This paper was also published in Insect Science International. That's a human international journal for students. Green butterfly. Green butterfly, Phoenicia Lucilia Cericata. It is among the cohort of flies that frequently visit freezing sites within and around human dwellings. This study was therefore to identify the cohort of microbes associated with Lucilia Cericata. Several bacteria were isolated from their external position. Prevalence within the neighborhood of 50% of all bacteria isolated were Staphylococcus aureus and Lepidobacillus species. Eucheretia coli was an ubiquitous species across the three locations from the Ibonacolor facility. This study re-emphasized the need for maintenance of high sanitary standards around the world. Municipal solid waste management has in recent times been regarded as one of the most challenging environmental issues facing developing countries. The use of most of the domestic for composting was solid waste. The study revealed that the city municipal waste is compostable and most of the domestic method inducement leads to improved compost which contains a higher nutrient quality, especially in the production of nitrogen, phosphate, and potassium, that are instrumental in plant using Azuma et al. 2014. Imagine the benefits derived from such a nutrient. This paper, this was a master's student, Azuma et al., who came to me and said she was interested in composting. I said, how are you going to do that? I wanted to know whether she knew what she said. She said she is going to look at iron and said she was interested in composting. So I said, that is to make it a conclusion. She is going to look at because any research that does not have value for the control is not a good research. It must be valuable for the control. I guess. That's why I said, I don't want to have a watch. I have a watch in this paper. So my name is in view in the world of science. My name is within the scene. All the papers that came to energy and environmental science. In 2014, my own was present. From the whole world, the papers that came from the whole world. Constantly appraise the status of half life in human and livestock. The objective, therefore, of this collector is to assess the distribution, abundance of various surveillance species, hostile development, dissemination, waste composition, downer activities of hostile. The objective, the market and cafeteria hampers the core of the combination of the sex ratio of males to females was 1:2 was set to the ratio of 1:1. Market as a potato at midday should be determined. The sex ratio of males to females was 1:2. Bedbugs are blood sucking cancers of human heart, which will be investigated and caused. We've seen that at this case. The resting site reference of bedbugs was therefore investigated. See, and with tumors, which was collected from various nursing sites, eggs of seed, crab of seed, space between plywood and iron frame of seed, male and female seed heterozygous have peaked in space between plywood and iron frame of seed, the males being more than the size of the ratio 3:1. While the freshly blood-fed females peaked in abundance of the site, the gravity had its bulk eggs of seed. I got one of that boy. Space between plywood and iron frame is target for the side. Any place that the implication of this is that any space that provides high, a place for high. Mice have been defined as the infestation of live vertebrate animals with the various larvae, which at least for certain period feed on the host, dead or living tissue, liquid body substance, or ingested food. 10th, 1965. The occurrence of mice flies on livestock was therefore investigated. Mice flies were collected from cattle, pig, poultry, and 11 species were recorded. And these include Fania regularis, Gastrophilus species, Mosca domestica, Megalocilia scalaris, Chrysomna basania, Fania scalaris, Dematobia hominis, Sarcophaga hemorrhagoidalis, Sarcophaga canaria, Ostrus ovis, and Hypocosca maculata. In decreasing order of importance, Ibodeon and Orissa 2005. The sex ratio of male to female in cattle was 1:1. Except in the month of July, the ratio of 2:1, and October with a ratio of 1:3. Control, therefore, should be done in October where there are more females. Ectoparasite carrying flies. Most cyclorhabdous dependents are quite harmful as they are non-biting, but going to their filthy habits are able to convey pathogenic organisms such as lice, flies, mice, from fields to food, humans, and their livestock. As Brunner and Thompson 1978, the occurrence of ectoparasite on cyclorhabdous nuclei will be therefore investigated. Four species, Mosca domestica, Lucilia caesar, Drosophila melanogaster, and Paracolonella frontalis, were found to harbor ectoparasite. This brings to the fore the importance of sanitation in reducing abundance of these flies as they are carriers of ectoparasite. Some flies. Some flies, some aspects of the balance of some flies was investigated. The potassium collected from human dwellings and farmlands. There was peak abundance in April to July. The males were more than females in ratio 3:1. The potassium were more in the evening than morning, and in human dwellings, residents, and country crops. I got your animal surround. Control with insecticides is better carried out from April to July. Please. Fleas are a group of wingless, laterally compressed, blood-sucking ectoparasites with shape suited for creeping through hairs and feathers. The work was aimed at determining the flea host preference, seasonal abundance, predation size, and spatial distribution. The species recorded with telocephalus phallus and telocephalus phallus, that is the cat's flea. So control should be done during March because that is where they have the highest abundance. Biting mimics. Biting midges, the some of the aspects, bowel dumping, biting was also done, and we found that C. nucola was more common in cattle than in combination of cattle, sheep, and goat. Control should be done in August and September because that was where you have cattle. Mice and lice. So mice and lice was investigated, and we got 6 species, 2 mice and 4 lice. Livestock, close associate of man, so constant attention should be
advocate to reduce their minds and lives in the system, considering the prevention sites. Ticks are blood sucking obligate ectoparasites on mammals, birds, and reptiles throughout the world. We worked on the ecological aspect of tick infestation, took samples from dogs, cattle, goats, sheep, and several other animals, and we found 5 species of ticks in Blumner, Vercator, Antidurus, Mombasa, Recephalus, and Massey, Ophilus, Nicolobatus, Demacentor, and Tessonite. Acknowledgements. I express my profound gratitude to God Almighty for taking me this far. I cannot thank Him enough. I have always believed in Him, and He has never failed. I am grateful to Madam Vice Chancellor, Professor L. R. Salami, for approving my long-awaited inaugural lecture, and I wish her the best my life has got to offer. I say thanks to a million to my mentors, Professor J. I. Akko of Pleasant Memory, Professor C. O. O'Leary, and Professor J. O. Oneka, also of Pleasant Memory. I thank Dr. C. D. Ekolo, who supervised my PhD. Thanks also to late Professor S. I. Okiwelu, who was a wonderful friend. I pray that God Almighty will keep you in the bosom forever. There are several people that I need to mention here, but they are writing my book. You better you pick up my book. So I humbly want to thank my wives. I have 2 of them. Mrs. Patience Igodion. And Dr. Mrs. Scholastica Ate Igodion. That is yes. They fed me in all ways, and I grew in all ways. I am a talented youth. I want to thank them eternally. Thank you. Conclusion, Madam Vice Chancellor, ma'am, I have shown that nothing meaningful can be done about the control of an insect vector without knowledge of its biology. Insect vector has been shown as an unfavorable visitor. The strategy includes breeding, feeding, and resting habits. It was revealed that these strategies can be used for control purposes. The lecture disclosed the strategy of mosquito, black fly, cockroaches, green butterfly, house fly, bed bug, mysis fly, ectoparasites, carrying flies, sand fly, fleas, biting leeches, mites, flies, and ticks. Usage ranges from environmental manipulation to environmental manipulation to insecticide application. The lecture clearly showed the importance of housefly moisture domination in composting, which turned out to be better than other methods for plant production and environmental waste management. This method, if applied, will lead to proper recycling of organic waste, hence producing the so much desired green environment. Importance of medical insect in entomophagy, feeding on insects by humans and animals, was revealed. This will not only reduce the population of the vector, but also produce alternative protein for livestock. Application of control measures by the use of botanical insecticides against the most dreaded malaria vector, Anopheles gabbiae, is shown to be as effective as synthetic insecticides. I hereby recommend the following. Nigerian government should make use of their professors and doctors by providing them enough money for research, especially in the area of insect vector control. A healthy nation cannot maintain its health status without continuous surveillance of vector population. It is time to harness the stale resources from insects through which biogas can be produced, best compost can be developed, and livestock can be properly fed. Sanitation should be the order of the day. It is written, cleanliness is next to godliness. The Lord God Almighty bless us with good health from clean environment, which renews itself. One of the greatest recyclers in nature is the housefly matter. Why not produce them in abundance to clean the environment and produce more food for the ever-increasing population? The federal government is invited to establish relationships with university professors to achieve this purpose. The era of research proposal is over. If there is an amount allocated to research, share it equally among the professors and doctors, who must give report at the end of the academic session. Otherwise, nothing will be received the next session. The only job the professor and the doctor enjoys doing is research. Each of them is in specific area which needs to be explored. This cannot be done without money. telling an English professor to approve the research proposal of a scientist is not tenable. Research output must be transformed into language that individuals can understand so and so be able to use it. Thank you, and God bless you.
The Vice Chancellor to give a recap of the lecture. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, you will all agree with me that he has done justice to the topic. The strategy of our unfavorable visitor, can we use it? He has shown that nothing meaningful can be done about the control of an insect vector without the knowledge of its biodynamics. The insect vector has been shown as our unfavorable visitor. Its strategy includes its breathing, feeding, and resting habits. It was revealed that these strategies can be used for control purposes. The lecture disclosed the strategies of mosquito, black fly, cockroaches, green bottle fly, house fly, bed bug, miasis fly, ectoparasite carrying flies, sand fly, fleas, biting midges, mites, lice, and ticks. Usage ranges from environmental manipulation to insecticide application. The lecture clearly showed the importance of the house fly, Musca domestica, in composting, which turns out to be better than other methods of plant production and environmental waste management. This method, if applied, will lead to proper recycling of organic waste, hence producing the so much desired clean environment. The importance of medical insects in entomophagy, that's feeding on insects by humans and animals, was revealed in the lecture. This will not only reduce the population of the vector, but also produce alternative source of protein for livestock. Application of control measures by the use of botanical insecticide against the most dreaded malaria vector, Anopheles gangae, is shown to be as effective as synthetic insecticide. Thank you very much for listening, and God bless you all.
Please a round of applause as we invite our lecturer to be decorated by the Vice Chancellor. Please may I invite the new family of the inaugural lecturer to come off stage and join him. Thank you. The immediate family, please come off stage and join him. Please also welcome Air Officer David Oganguan, retired, you're welcome, sir. Chief O.J. Asiko, Professor Emeritus. Philip Usiosefe, if I'm weary, you're welcome.
Dr. Mrs. Scholastica Ibudion, you're welcome, ma'am. Mrs. Ewere Morage, you're welcome. Aye G. C., you're welcome. Anthony Ihile, you're welcome. Professor Mrs. Ofowe, you're welcome, ma'am. Professor Ray Ozola, you are welcome. Professor Frederick Ekaise, you are welcome. Professor Doctor, Professor D. E. Obedford, you are welcome. Emeritus Professor Raymond Elaho, you are welcome. Venerable Professor Wanzian, you are welcome. Professor Nosa Elafona, you are welcome. Professor Samson Edo, former Dean of Social Sciences, you're welcome. Professor MSO ICM, you're welcome. Professor Jacob Ehobo, you're welcome. And Professor Mike Omogwarade, you're welcome. Please, everyone, you're welcome. And thank you, you're welcome. Please, let's remain seated while this is going on. Session out of the hall. Thank you.